we are seeing here. And in this area, you see the conglomerate and the traction bronchiectasis. Cystic changes are seen here in this place. So pneumothorax with a traction bronchiectasis of the right lower lobe. Because of the pneumothorax, there is some crowding of the parenchymal tissue is there. If you see here, these are all the sparse ones, but whereas here it is crowded, and also here like a small collapse, complete collapse, and the pneumothorax is occupying the entire right hemithorax. This side, that small one. Bulla will have it in separately, but this is pneumothorax only, sir. Pneumothorax. Bulla will have a thin wall.
We put a 22 size intercostal tube inserted underwater seat. Next. He recovered, the pneumothorax disappeared. Comment on next.
Chest tube. Chest tube placed in right position, expansion of the lung, you can see the bronchovascular markings also seen up to the periphery. So good expansion of the lung is there, and that intercostal tube is kept it in a right place. This is small surgical emphysema that will heal on its own.
The left side markings are seen.
Yes. Left side, sir.
No markings are seen.
No, this is picture was not taken. Yes. Yes. Here also like that only. This is taken that light for, it is not taken properly, that one. And you can see that parenchymal lesion which is coming up here. After the expansion of the lung, right upper lobe, you can see the parenchymal lesion. Here also you can see that parenchymal lesion, totally that pneumothorax has expanded completely, that has gone. Yes. Yes, sir. Yes.
Treatment was inhaled and treatment liver salbutamol, terbinafine, and antibiotic. Next. Again, May 2017, had anterior chest pain, right side, sudden in nature, this week. Next. Respiratory rate 28, pulse 112, tachycardia, BP 110/70. Next. X-ray chest PAVU, right pneumothorax. Within a matter of 1 month, he had the second attack.
What will happen here, this the parenchymal lesion where there is the immunoresistance is there and the thinning will be there. So when he breathes or coughs, no, what will happen? This will cause the recurrent pneumothorax. This could be the cause for the recurrent pneumothorax. Again, CT will pick up. The idea of that, doing HRCT where you can pick up the small pneumothorax like this also. See, you can see that it is from the lower lobe. The expansion of the upper lobe is there, but whereas the lower lobe, that it is a partial like that, under the mid zone, under the lower zone, the pneumothorax is there. Collapse of the lung towards the hilum is seen. This is in the mediastinal window. See, this is, you are seeing the black lung. This is, we call it as a mediastinal window, where we can look for the any mediastinal lymph nodes are there. I don't see any mediastinal lymph nodes here. See, that cicatrization of the lung. You can see it is in towards the hilum, cicatrization, and the pneumothorax is seen here, pneumothorax is seen here, pneumothorax is seen here. At a lower cut, you can see that entire lower lobe, very separately it is seen, and the cystic bronchiectasis changes also seen in the right lower lobe.
Will you be able to pick up a bronchopleural fistula on this?
Yes. Yes.
CT?
Yes, we can pick it up. See, our previous. See, if this is the pneumothorax, and here you will see this, these are all the bronchus area. And the communication will be there. Two tubular structure you'll see, that is bronchopleural fistula. Sometimes amoebic liver abscess which has ruptured, patient will be coughing out the amoebic abscess. So at that time you will see the communication from the liver to the pleura, bronchus, and it is coming out. So the communication, and you do a reconstruction.
Doctor, mummy boma.
Yes, reconstruction. We will be able to track that part. Here nothing is there.
Again, we inserted the 22 size
intercostal tube, he recovered. Next. After 3 days, we travel, he again developed right pneumothorax, planned colectomy. Now I invite Dr. Ajay Narasimhan. We are expanding our thoracic surgery department in public health center. He has joined us. He did surgery. I request him to proceed what he did in the case.
Okay. As we saw, can we have the CT pictures?
Back. Yeah. See here, in the right upper lobe, there are small areas of pulla. And because of his age and he is a smoker, most likely he will be having COPD, for which he has had an acute exacerbation and a third pneumothorax within 1 month. Which means definitely is an indication for either pleural disease or if there is an existing pulla, we need to go ahead and do a pullectomy. So what we planned was to do a wax pullectomy and along with it combined with the pleural disease. So we went in, I don't have the surgery pictures with me. We went in and did a wax pullectomy, video assisted thoracic. Wax is video assisted thoracoscopic surgery, where you make a small incision around 4 to 5 centimeters in the thorax. We insert a thoracoscope and with specialized instruments we staple the pulla. We staple this part of the lung. This part, we just use 3 staplers, 1, 2, 3, and then remove this part of the lung which was bulless in nature. We found few small bullet, after which the lung expanded, but there still continues to be airlift. He is recovering. We did the surgery just 2 days back. He is still in the ICU, is recovering. There is still some amount of airlift. These patients with COPD, we always expect a prolonged postoperative course because the other lung, even though this part of the lung has the bullous disease, even the other parts of the lung would have been affected by the smoking, and the recovery is not as smooth as we expect in a normal non-smoker's lung. So he's still in the ICU, he's recovering. We hope to pull out the ICD in maybe a couple of days or maybe 1 week or something. Give it up.
What is the plan
for pneumonectomy
instead of stapling and so on? I think that will...
He won't withstand a pneumonectomy, sir. He is a COPD patient, his age is almost 60. He is not fit for a pneumonectomy. Pneumonectomy is a very morbid procedure, and right pneumonectomy is a very, very morbid procedure.
You know, the way we have done the 3 times stapling pneumothorax is coming back repeatedly.
Pneumonectomy is not the procedure of choice, but pneumonectomy needs to be done.
No, pneumothorax recurrently is going to the hospital.
That's why we have removed the part of the lung which is causing the pneumothorax.
Thank you very much for Dr. Professor Rangasayan for the exhibition. And the moral of the story is this. Today, our neurosurgeon has left. Deep brain stimulation for alcoholic is not the answer. Answer for alcoholic addiction is not to drink. Stop alcohol. The recurrent pneumothorax, the answer is bullectomy, we have done it. But the answer is not to smoke. Not to smoke when you are doing so, you don't get COPD. These are the basic fundamentals they forget. We get into the problems. I sincerely thank the organizers for allowing me to continue. Please, I again invite all of you to come and present your cases so that our subject matter becomes absolutely broad-based as directed by the research.
Thank you, sir. We request Dr. Perumal to hand over his certificate of appreciation to Dr. Chandrasekharan. I request Dr. Sandeep to propose a word of thanks, and with that we close the forum back in CME. Thank you, sir.